Welcome back to the channel. In this new video, I'm going to cover some new labs published by PortSwigger regarding GraphQL API vulnerabilities. GraphQL vulnerabilities generally arise due to the implementation and design flaws. For example, introspection feature may be left active, enabling attackers to query the API in order to glean information about the schema. But there are other attacks that you can perform also with other vulnerability, mixed one, such as CSRF exploit and others that we will see in the other labs. But mainly in this one, we will just focus on some hidden posts and some hidden fields that we can retrieve through the GraphQL API endpoints. Normally, if you find like a GraphQL API or something that is suspicious, you can send this type of query and you will get a response, which is this one. This response will allow you to confirm that behind the scenes there is a GraphQL endpoint. Normally, the GraphQL endpoints are this one, the common ones. To make it work, sometimes you need to add the version 1 or version 2 at the end of the string. But in particular, sometimes there are some introspection queries that you're not able to perform because the post request is not available. So you need to work with the GET request and URL encode all the payload. We will see in other labs how to deal with it. But now let's focus in the lab. But firstly, I want to suggest to solve this lab and even in future to handle with all GraphQL API vulnerabilities is suggested to install this kind of extension, which is eMLQL. This extension will help you to visualize more in an easy way the query, and also there is internally a scanner which can be useful to perform some introspection queries. Other features are available, but you will discover it just using it, because most of the labs are not covering all the features of the extension. But let's focus now in the lab. The lab is a blog page which contains an hidden blog post not available in the front end, and you can retrieve it through the GraphQL API. And with this, and with this blog post that you will find the secret password. The secret password will be the solution for the lab. Normally, when you are in a new lab, it's always suggested to perform some manual action just to allow Burp suite to grab all the queries that are running in background. So now let's shift to Burp suite, and you can see here there is a folder, GraphQL version 1, which has internally two requests. The first one is the request to get one blog post, and the second one is the request to get all the blog posts available. In fact, as you can see here, the response is quite structured, but there are almost all the blog posts, unless the ID3. And another key thing that I want to show you is that GraphQL endpoints, if you don't submit like the field that you want, you can retrieve just a partial response. And this will be also useful to retrieve some hidden fields. In this case, let's try test. We can see that there will be an error because test in type is undefined in blog post. So now we need to find out how can we see all the fields available in the blog post. The answer is through the introspection query. To perform a scanner into the introspection query, we can copy the endpoints of the GraphQL and load it into the scanner. Once we loaded it, we can see that here the extension will run introspection query. This introspection query will give us all the fields available for the blog post object and also other key things concerning the GraphQL implementation. And as you can see here, the fields are the one that we have already seen, which is ID, image, title, author, date, summary, paragraph. But there is also an hidden field, which is post password, not available at first. And this will be the one that we need. In fact, if we go here in get blog post, we can see that the ID3 is available. And just to have a better view, I want to just retrieve post password. And as you can see, this is just the field that we need. another thing just for the sake of the curiosity, this field was available just in the ID blog post tree. So now let's copy this string, which could be an hash string, as I assume, and let's submit the solution to the lab. As you can see, in this way we will solve the lab. Thank you for the attention. See you in the next video.